Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can reverse a string in three different ways. So let's go to Eclipse. Now here I have already created one project called Java programming, and inside this I'm going to create a new class. Now let's create a new class. I will name it as reverse string, and I'm also taking this main method and click on the finish. Now the first approach is to reverse a string using concatenation operator. The first approach is using string concatenation operator. So here we need to write our own logic. Now let me just first of all see how we can reverse a string. What is the logic behind this? So let me just open my notepad and how we can reverse a string. So let me just take a small string here. Let us say I have A, B, C, D. So I have four character string. So let's say A, B, C, D. Now I want to reverse this. This is basically a string variable and I want to reverse this. So to reverse this, what I can do is, first of all, I need to find out length of a string. So currently the length of a string is four. So four characters we have. After that, I can just write one for loop in which I will just iterate from the end like this. So how many times we need to iterate? Four times I will iterate. So every time when I iterate, I will extract the character from this link. So I can extract the character from the string and I will add that character in some other variable called as a reverse variable. Let's say I have extracted last character D and which is assigned to the reverse. After that, again, I will go to the next level. I'll extract the character C, then I will add this C character with existing one. So here D is already there in the reverse. Now again, I'm adding C here and I'm concatenating C here. And again, go to the next level and extract the B, then add this character to the existing characters, that is B. And again, it will go to the next level and extract the character A and add that character here. So here we are keep on concatenating the character. So final string will be D, C, B, A. This is a reverse string. So how many times we need to go back and extract the values? That depends on the length of a string. So we have to use two string methods here. One is length. The other one is to extract the character from the string, we use caret method. Okay, one is length method, the other one is caret method. So there are two methods I'm going to use along with the concatenation operator. So this is the logic, I'm going to write it now. Now let's go here, program. So first of all, let me define a string variable here. Let's say string str, I'm declaring a string variable and I'll just give some simple one. Let's say ABCD, four characters we have inside the string. And also I will define one more variable or string variable, which is reverse, to store the reverse number. And currently I don't have any reverse value, so I'm just making it as a null, the default value. Now I'm going to show you how we can reverse this. So first of all, let me just write a loop statement directly, or we can just find out length of a string. So how to find out the length of a string? So let me create one integer variable, length is equal to str.length. So this will give you length of a string. This will give you length of a string. So how many characters we have? Four characters we have. So this will give you four characters. Means it will start from one. One, two, three, four. So total characters are four. Now, if you want to extract a specific character from this, I need to specify caret of index number. So this is the method. Let's say I have a string like str.caret of, when I say some index number here, when I say zero, it will give you the first character. When I say one, it will give you second character. When I say two, next character. Four, three, next character. So by default, index will start from zero. As per caret method, index will start from zero. So as per caret method, how many characters we have? One, two, three, four characters we have, because index is starting from zero. So zero, one, two, three. So totally three are there if I start index from zero. So when I repeat the loop for every character, we need to repeat four times because length is four, but index we need to start from zero. Okay, so that's the reason what we have to do is Caret method will start from zero itself, right? So now let me just write one small loop for integer I is equal to, so I need to start from the end. So 4 representing end value, right? The length is having end value, 4 characters. So here I'll say length because it is saying 4. But as per caret method, index will start from 0. So 0, 1, 2 and 3 is also there. But 4 is not considered, right? So for that, what we have to do is we need to decrease this value by 1. So I make it as a 1. So now I value becomes 3 now. So I value becomes 3. So here I'll say the condition called I greater than or equal to 0. So what does that mean is whenever I value becomes 0, okay, as soon as I value becomes 0, even 0 is also fine because caret method will count index from 0 itself. So as soon as I value becomes less than 0, that means the condition become false. So what does it mean is I value should always greater than or equal to 0. And then I am doing I minus minus. Means here we need to go to the reverse way. First we need to go to the D, C, B and A. So I am starting from the end, that is 3. And every time I'm checking, the iteration is greater than or equal to 0. The I value is greater than or equal to 0. And every time I'm decreasing the I value. That means we need to go to the reverse direction. Now inside the for loop, I already created one reverse variable, right? So let's take that reverse variable is equal to, here I'll say reverse plus, I need to capture the last character. So I need to extract the last character, after that before character, and then keep on extracting each and every character. So here we need to extract the last character. For that we have to use a method called caret. So we already have string variable. From this string variable I'm extracting by using caret method, I'm extracting the last value. So here I'll pass I value as an index value. Now what this expression will do is from the string it will extract the character which is there inside this position and add that value into the reverse variable. So currently I is equal to 3 and here currently I value is equal to 3. So condition is true. Now it will come inside the loop. So here what will happen is here caret of I. So currently I value is 3. So caret of 3, what this will give you, caret of 3 means, so we have 0, 1, 2, 3. So it will return D here. So this is a D now. So currently the D will be assigned to the reverse. Now D will be assigned here inside the reverse variable. Now current value of reverse is D. Now again it will go up. Now I will be decremented by 1. So now this becomes 2 now. I value becomes 2 now. So again this condition is true. So 2 greater than or equal to 0, which is true. Now again come inside the loop. Now this expression will execute one more time. So this time from the same string I'm extracting the second character because I value is equal to 2 now. So I value is equal to 2 now. So from the second place, which character we have in this string? This is 0, 1, 2. So in the second position, we have a C. So this will extract the C. And in the reverse, we already have D earlier. Now the C will be concatenated with the existing value. Now the C will be added here. Now again, it will go up. Now I value minus minus, so it will becomes 1 now. So again, condition is true. Again, it will come here. Now from the string, it will extract the first character. So I value currently is 1, so it will extract the first character. So what is the first character here? This is 0 and 1. In the first position, we have B. So already in the reverse, these two characters we have. But currently, we are extracting one more character, that is B. Now the B will be concatenated with the existing value. So again, it will go up. Now this time I value becomes 0. So now again, condition is true. So 0 greater than equal to 0, condition is true. Now again, come inside the loop. So here caret of I. So currently I value is 0. So from this string, it will extract the 0 element or 0 value, that is A. And that will be appended to the existing value, that is reverse. So here A will be appended. So after that, I value becomes minus 1. So as soon as I value becomes minus 1, then this condition becomes false. Then it will come out from this loop statement. Now, after coming out from this loop statement, the final value which is there inside the reverse variable is reversed value. So that we need to print it here. So I'll say system.out.println. I'll just print a reverse string. Reverse string is, I'm just printing the reverse variable. That's it. So now this will print the reverse value. So now let's try this. Run as Java application. So now the reverse string is null and DCB also displaying, and we should not print null here. So because we make it as a null here, and it is printing null as well as this one. So we need to, so here we initially assign null to the reverse. So for that reason, what it is doing is it is adding all the characters with the existing value. So what I can do is I can just make it as empty instead of making null, right? So now we can make this as a null, empty, and then execute our script one more time. And now it will give you a reverse value, right? So this is how we can write a logic to reverse a string. Now I will show you another way of reversing this particular string. So this time I'm going to use a character array. So let me just comment this, this particular logic. And the second approach is by using character array, we can do that. So the next thing is, next approach is using character array. So how we can reverse a string by using character array. So let me just write it here. So how to reverse a string using character array. So first of all, what I have to do is, we already created one string variable and which contains a value. Now I will convert this string into character array. That means each and every character I will separate, then I'll store all the characters in character array. So let me just create one character array. So let's say char a and is equal to, so I want to convert this string into character array. So for that, we have a method called the string variable dot, there is a method called to char array. Let's say to char array, and this particular method will convert the string into multiple paths. Now string into multiple characters. Now a, b, c, d will be stored inside this character array. Now how it is going to work internally is, this is going to create a character array like this, and inside this it will allocate four locations. And here it will add values like this. Here it will be A, and it will be and C and D. So now the str will be divided into multiple characters, and all the characters will be stored inside this character array. So now this is a character array. So from this character array, I need to read the values from the end, not from the beginning. So for that, what you have to do is, we have to write an index. Let's say here index is 0, 1, 2, and 3. So if I find length of this array, which will give you 4, right? So that means it is index is starting from 0. I'll say n 4 minus 1. So 3 times I need to, 4 times I need to repeat the loop, and all the values I will extract one after another. So I will start from the reverse way. So first I will extract the first character, add that character into some reverse variable. After that, I will add another character and add that value into the reverse variable again. Similarly, I will extract each and every individual values from this character array. Then add all the values, all the characters into this particular reverse variable. Now we'll see how we can do this. So here, so I have just created one character array. So I have stored all the string characters into a single character array. Now here I will write, let's find out the length of an array. So how to find length here? A dot length. So this will give you length of an array. I can store that in some variable called length. So accordingly, I'll write one for loop statement. So I need to start from the end. So I need to start from the end. So the length is written 4 here because it will count from the 0. But I need to start from 3 here because index will 0. So here I'll say the initial value of iteration is, I'll say n minus 1 because that is a 3. Now always I need to make sure I value greater than 0. Okay, I value greater than or equal to 0. So that's a condition, I greater than or equal to 0. And then I minus minus, so that I need to go back in descending order. So 3, 2, 1, and finally 0. Now here, I already created one reverse variable with empty value. I'm using that reverse variable equal to reverse plus. I need to extract the value from array. So how we can extract? By passing index number. So array name and current value of I, I'll passing as an index. So now the reverse will have the value. So now how it is going to work? So here I is equal to this is length minus one, right? Now let's see how it is going to work. So initially here the I value is length is 4 because I'll say minus 1 here. So it will start from 3. So currently I value is 3. Now the condition is true. Then it will come here. So currently reverse doesn't have anything, empty. Now A of I. So currently I value is 3. So A of 3 means A of 3 we have a one character, that is D. Now D will be assigned to this reverse variable. Now the current value of reverse is D. Now after that it will go up again. So I minus minus, so I value will be decreased by 1. So it will becomes a 2 now. Now again condition is true, 2 greater than or equal to 0. Again now it comes inside the loop. So here this time I value is equal to 2. So A of 2 means it will retrieve C. Now already in the reverse we have a D. Now it will go and add C here, concatenate C here. Now again it will go up. Now I value becomes 1. I minus minus, I value becomes 1. Now again 1 greater than or equal to 0, condition is true. Now from the first place we have a B. Now this time it will extract B. A of I means B, and whatever value we already have in the reverse DC, the B will be appended to the existing value. So it is concatenated. And again it will go up. Now I value becomes 0. Now the condition is again true. So 0 greater than or equal to 0 is condition is true. Now again it will come here. So A of 1 means A of 0, that is A, will be concatenated with the existing value, that is A here. Now after again it will go up. Now I value becomes minus 1. So as soon as I value becomes minus 1, then condition become false. Then it will exit from the for loop. So once it is exited from the for loop, I can just print the reverse variable value here. So now this will print reverse string is whatever the reverse we have inside this, we have a reversed value. So that I am printing here. So this is another way of reversing a string by using character array. Now let's execute. So right click, run as Java application. So now you can see it is exactly reversed the value. So this is a one approach to reverse a string by using character array. So there is also another way we can do this by using string buffer class. Now let me just comment this. We can also reverse a string by using string buffer class. So how we can do this? So in the third approach, using string buffer class, we can reverse a string. So let me show you how we can do this. So we already have this string ABCD, which is a string variable. Now here I will create one object for string buffer class. Let me create a string buffer SB is equal to new string buffer. I'm just creating an object for string buffer, and here I will pass this string value. So str value, I am passing it here. So now SB is contains a str, so string. Now I need to reverse it. So we can directly have a reverse method which we can apply on this particular string buffer variable. So simply I can say SB dot reverse. So direct method is available. So this will reverse our string. Now let's put that into print statement. System dot out dot println. I'll say SB dot reverse and semicolon. So this particular method will reverse the value which is there inside this string buffer variable. That's it. So now let's execute Java application. Now it returns the reverse variable, reverse value. Okay, so this is how we can reverse a string in multiple ways. The first approach is by using concatenation operator, and here we make use of length and caret method. The second approach is by using character array, and third approach is by using string buffer class. We can directly apply the reverse method. So this is how we can reverse a string in Java. All right. So So that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.